Hello friends, so it's me Varun. So in the previous session we have been covering a lot of theory related to synchronous generators, right? We derived the equivalent circuit, we derived the phasor diagram. In fact, in the previous session we have seen actually the operation of a synchronous generator alone when it is supplying to a load. So it has been a lot of theory till now. So I thought that why can't we spend a couple of lectures, maybe two or three lectures exclusively on numericals. Alright, so today we are going to start with certain numericals on the synchronous generator. So this numerical has a lot of parts in it, so that the complaint gets over here. So we will be splitting it into two lectures. So we will cover these first three concepts here, and the last three concepts we will cover in the next lecture, hopefully, depending upon the time. So let us see what is a numerical now. So it is told that it is a 480 volt 60 hertz delta connected generator. So these words are very important, alright. So 480 volt 60 hertz delta connected generator with synchronous generator, okay, it's 0.1 ohm per phase, and the resistance RA, armature resistance, is given as 0.015 ohms per phase, alright. And they have also given some conditions here at full load condition. Okay, they have told at full load condition, the IL, okay, that means the current which is reaching the load is 1200 ampere. So the full load current here is 1200 ampere. And it is at point power factor, 8 power factor lagging. Okay, so what they mean by full load is a load which is demanding 1200 ampere at 0.8 power factor. Okay. And at that same condition, they have given two conditions at full load. The friction and windage loss at full load is 40 kilowatts, and the core loss and 30 kilo core loss is equal to 30 kilowatts. Okay. So first, what they have asked is, what is the speed of rotation of the generator? Okay. So let us do that first. What is the speed of rotation of the generator? Okay. So you know that the speed of rotation of the generator is the synchronous speed, ns is equal to 120 into f by p. Right, 120 into f by p. So let us see what all information we are having. So we are having, this is 60 hertz, and I forgot to write here, it is a 4-pole generator. Alright, 4-pole, so I forgot to write that. It's a 4-pole generator. So they have given that frequency to be operated is at 60 hertz, and this is 4 poles. Okay, so if you substitute that here, so you get 120 into 60 divided by how much? 4. So this will give you around 1800 RPM. Please use your calculators to do all these problems. I am already writing this because I have already done the calculations myself. Okay, so let us move to the next question. First part is easy. So the second part is, how much field current has to be supplied to make the terminal voltage of the generator 480 volts at no load condition. Okay, so what they are telling is that, what is the generator that we are having? We are having a delta connected generator, right? So I am not putting the EMFs here now at presently, just to not to clutter the diagram here. So what they are telling is that you are having a delta connected generator like this, right? You are having a delta connected generator like this. So they are telling, at the no load condition, when you are driving the motor, okay, driving the generator, sorry, what field current, what is the IF? IF is equal to what? Okay, when VT is equal to 480 volt, okay, at no load condition, at no load. Okay, that means you are not connecting any load, and so they are asking, this is the terminal voltage, right? This is VT, okay, and between the phases you call it as V phase. Okay, so they are asking, if you connect a voltmeter here, okay, and the generator is at no load condition, how much field current I should get if I am getting 480 volts, how much field current I have to give to get 480 volt at the no load condition. In all such problems we should have the OCC characteristic, alright. So basically the concept here is that you find the value of the internal voltage EA, okay. So what is the OCC made up of? The OCC is the characteristic open circuit terminal voltage, which is also same as the internal generated voltage at open circuit, at open circuit condition, right. See, VT or the V phase is same as the internal generated voltage at open circuit characteristics, at open circuit. So there, what basically we have to do is that you find the value of EA, okay, you find the value of EA, and for that corresponding value of EA you find the value of the field current. Okay, so this is a very simple problem. So you know that in the open circuit characteristic, the EA, okay, EA will be equal to the V phase. right? EA is equal to V phase. But now they have given the VT value. Okay, but for a delta connection, VT is same as the V phase value. Okay, for delta connection, VT is same as V phase value. So this is same as VT and this is 480 volt. So at no load condition, what is EA value? EA at no load is same as V phase. In delta connection, it is same as VT and that is equal to 480 volts. So if you look at the diagram here, 480 volts comes somewhere around here, right? So if you just plot it here like this, okay, you will get the value. In the book, it is not very clear at what point here. So let's look at the value what we are getting. Okay, so you put this in the OCC. Okay, from the OCC, we will get IF to be equal to around 4.8 amperes. Okay, that is what they have given in the book. So corresponding to EA is equal to 480 volt, IF will be 4.8 amperes. What does that mean? If the generator is rotating, okay, at 1800 RPM, if you give 4.8 amperes as the field current, the terminal voltage at open circuit will be 480 volts. Okay, that is the understanding. Now the third part of the question is more interesting. At IL is equal to 1200 amperes, that means you are connecting a load and the load is a 0.8 power factor lagging load. What is the EA required to maintain VT is equal to 480 volt? Okay, so let us just put down that once again here. So let us quickly draw a small generator here. Now I am not marking the EMFs because marking those circles takes me a lot of time. So what they are asking is that now you have connected a load here. Okay. Now you have connected a load. Okay. So this generator is feeding a load and they are telling that the load is drawing 1200 amperes and the load power factor is 0.8 power factor lagging condition. Okay. It is lagging condition. So what they are asking, what is the IF? What is the IF? Okay. In this, what is the IF for VT to be is equal to 480 volt at given IL? Okay, so they are telling that this much amount of current is flowing. So naturally, if EA was 480 volt, EA will drop down and come less than 480 volt, right? So they are telling that you increase the excitation a little bit so that at terminals you get 480 volt. So naturally, if you are increasing the excitation, a little bit of EA also will increase, right? EA will increase. You will see that when we solve the problem. Okay. So let us do our question now. Now, till now, we have not used this type of notation, which I'm going to use now. But I think in the previous lecture, I have used this notation. But anyway, let us write the equation. You know that EA is equal to V phase plus IARA plus J into IA into XS. Okay. But these are all actually vector notations. Okay, these are all vector notations. So that you have to take into consideration whenever you are doing the problem in AC circuit especially. So if this is V phase, this is a lagging load, right? So IA is this. So this will be IARA. Okay. And this is J into IA into XS, right? And this is your EA. Okay. And the angle between EA and V phase is called delta. Angle between V phase and IA is theta, power factor, right? Some people call it phi, but here we are having the phase voltage also named as phi. So that is why I am taking it as theta. So here to write it as a vector notation, we have to write it like this. So EA angle, okay? How much is EA leading? V phase is the reference. So it is leading by delta. So EA angle delta is equal to V phase. Okay, now whenever you are using phasor equations, equations developed out of the phasor diagram, you have to always use phase values. Okay, remember, you have to always use phase values. So this is V phase angle 0 plus, okay, and what else will come? So IARA will come plus IARA. So IA is a vector itself. So IA, and it is lagging by an angle theta with respect to V phi, right? So it is IA minus theta, okay, into RA plus, okay, IA angle minus theta. So I am writing this term now. And then you are having this, I'll just put the J along with this XS, J into XS, right? So this is the equation, correct equation. So what they are asking is that for VT is equal to 480 volt, because this is a delta connection, VT will be same as V phase. Okay, Vt will be same as V phase. So they're telling what is the field current required so that the Vt will stay at 480 volt. Okay, so for that, first you have to find EI angle delta. And once you find EA angle delta, you can find the field current from the OCC. Okay. So EA angle delta. So now this is 480 angle 0. So why I am directly putting 480? Because this is a delta connection and Vt is equal to V phase. Okay. Angle 0. Plus. Now IA is not the line current. IA is through the armature. So that is a phase value. Okay. So in a delta connection, I'll just write it here. Okay. In a delta connection, the phase value will be IL divided by root 3, right? So in this case, the phase value is the armature current. And so here you have to put the phase value, okay? Remember, all these quantities are per phase quantities. Remember, whenever you are using a equivalent circuit diagram, or everything is in the per phase value. So this will become 1200 divided by root 3, okay? Line current was 1200, so IA is 1200 by root 3. And what is the power factor? Power factor cos theta. Power factor cos theta is equal to 0.8, right? Lagging. So theta will be equal to cos inverse of 0.8, which is equal to 36.86. All these values, by practicing problems, you have to memorize that cos inverse of 0.8 is 36.86. It should strike you always. Because in most of the numericals, the power factor is usually at 0.8 value. Okay, so this is minus 36.86 and into RA. How much was RA value? It is 0.015, right? 0.015 plus 1200 divided by root 3. Okay, and this is angle minus 36.86. Okay, and what is the excess value? Oh, I think we are just getting congested for space, right? So let me put it in the next page now. Sorry for that. Copy and paste. Yeah, that's better. So, and along with this, you are having this J into excess, right? So excess value was equal to 0.1. So this is into 0.1, and this J is usually a 90 degree. Okay, J is always a 90 degree. So J, you can put it as 90 degree. These all are AC fundamentals. So if you calculate this using a calculator, you will get EA angle delta to be equal to 532.155 angle 5.3 degree. Okay, so this is going to be your EA angle delta. But this is not the question. Your question is, what is the field current? So what is the meaning of this? To get 480 volt at the terminals, EA will not be 480 volt now. EA has to increase to 532.15. And how can EA increase? Because the speed is always constant. The only way is to increase flux, and only way to increase flux is to increase the IF. So let us see, for 532.15, what is the value? So 532 might be somewhere around here, right? So the value will be somewhere around 5 and 5.5. So from the book and the OCC, so here from the OCC, you will get that IF, okay, for this value will be equal to 5.7 amperes. Okay, you will get it to be 5.7 amperes. So what does this mean? So initially, how much was the IF? It was 4 point. At no load condition, to get the terminal voltage to 480 volt, you needed only 4.8 amperes because there was no load on the system. But once you load the system, you know that the voltage is going to drop. And therefore, to maintain the same terminal voltage, you will have to increase the value of IEA. And to increase the value of EA, you have to increase the value of IF. Therefore, if you increase the value to 5.7 ampere from 4.8 ampere, for this particular loading condition of 1200 ampere, you can get 480 volt at the terminal voltage. Okay, there's a lot of amperes and volts which I'm telling, but I hope you are understanding all these things. Okay, so those are three parts over now. So I think it's time to stop the lecture now. So the rest three we will follow in the next session. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Don't forget to watch the DC machines module, the AC machines fundamental module, and also the engineering circuit analysis present in the same channel. Till I see you in the next video, it's me Varun signing off, and have a great day. Thank you.